I'm sure a lot of us love to sew woven tops for ourselves, but sometimes we find ourselves struggling with fitting issues, issues with the shoulder, the back, the neckline, the bust, so many things. And this is the start of a new series, a fitting series that will be super useful for you, so keep watching. Hi sewing friends, I'm Karina from liftingpinsandneedles.com. Welcome to this channel that is all about sewing. Limitless Sewing, and today is the start of a brand new mini series on the channel. I've been very excited to share everything I have planned for this mini series, and also it's taken a lot of courage from my part to actually start it because I've been planning it for such a long time. If you've been a regular viewer or subscriber to Lifting Pins and Needles, you might have followed along with the Let's Sew Easy Pants series that I did last year for fitting pants, and it was such a huge success. I know it's been super helpful because I've received emails and comments, and I've seen my series shared all over the internet, and I know it's helped a lot of people, and that makes me super happy. So it was always in the works to do a fitting series for the upper body, always based on woven designs. I'm not going to tackle fitting knit garments because it's a whole nother can of worms. But actually, the woven garments, we are usually full of woven fabrics in our stash, beautiful woven fabrics, and sometimes we end up sewing knit things because, let's face it, sometimes the fitting could be easier. So I'm on an ambitious plan to create a series all about fitting. I would like to start by saying that our bodies are unique. There's nothing wrong with them. You know, we have a certain shape, a certain size. We have volumes in our upper body placed in different areas due to genetics and other factors. So it is pretty difficult to find a woven pattern that will just fit us straight out of the envelope and straight out of the box. There is usually going to be things that we need to tweak to fit these patterns onto ourselves. Now, if we didn't want to do any fitting at all, there's the other route of learning how to draft your own patterns, you know, according to your body measurements, have a block, and then create designs from your block so that you could wear whatever garment style you like with the base that already fits you. But I know a lot of people aren't willing to go and learn how to draft their own block and do that, and they just want to use a pattern that's already there. So I can do both. I can draft myself, and also I can see a pattern that I like and get it to fit me with some tweaks. Now, if I weren't on YouTube, I am sure that I would be using my blog a lot more, but I found over the years that when I create content around that, the views are terribly low. There is just not much interest in that sort of content. So that's why I don't create content around transforming my blog into other types of designs, although I can do that. I know the large majority of us want to use a style that was created by a designer that we like, and we would like to use that pattern there. So there are a couple of steps that are going to help us assess this pattern, do a few things to it before we can even cut out a muslin to check for the fit. I'm trying to plan this in a way that's going to make a lot of sense. I'm very focused on finding the ways that are going to be easier to understand, that are going to make sense. And the types of fitting adjustments, there are very many, many, many. If you look online for just one thing you want to correct on a pattern, if you want to make the shoulders narrower, you will find 10 ways to do it. So the ways that you'll see me doing it are the ways that make sense to me, the ways that I think will disrupt other areas less while keeping some of the seam lines the same. So you won't see me eyeballing or doing that sort of thing, or the approach that this works for me in this sort of series. I'm going to try and do my best to find the best ways to do these adjustments on a basic pattern. By basic pattern, I mean a woven top with a set-in sleeve. My only requisite here is that it has a bust start. There needs to be some type of shaping in this top. I'm not looking for woven tops that are swing style or super loose, boxy, dolman style sleeves. I'm not looking for those. I'm looking for patterns that will have a front and a back. You can have a center back seam. It's actually good that it is there in some of these designs, and you need a bust start. Whether the bust start is straight or slightly angled doesn't really matter, but that bust start is going to help us. When I mentioned bust cup sizes, these are sewing bust cup sizes. They're not actual cup sizes that you buy with your bra, so they are not cupping anything. It's basically the difference between your high bust and your full bust and how the garment falls on top. It's not cupping your bust from underneath like a bra actually is. So it's not the same. You could be an E cup size bra and then just be a B cup size in your sewing. So it's really nice to have that difference to measure yourself. And that's what I mean in regards to bust cup sizes in patterns here. So I have compiled a list of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 patterns that could work if you have these patterns or look for something similar like this. I think if you had any of these, you could get started and trying to see how to fit this type of garment onto yourself, you know, in the progression of all this series. I'm going to name them in no particular order of preference, just the way they made it onto my notebook here. And the first one is the Montrose top from Cashmere Patterns. This one is available in sizes 12 to 32. And this one has cup sizes C, D, E, F, and G, H. I know this pattern won't be suitable as a base to work on for people that are smaller than a size 12 or who have a smaller cup size, you know, A and B. That's why I've got a list of patterns here that could work. But this one's really cool. It has a back yoke, which I think is great for fitting. You know, don't think a yoke is something that is going to make fitting more difficult. Might make it a bit easier sometimes. And you have a dart on the side for your bust. So it meets the criteria. It is one that I would use. The other pattern I have on the list here is the Cadence Top and Dress from Love Notions. This is a top and a dress, but you know, if you could just use the top version, we're mainly focusing on tops for this series, not on dresses. Although the concepts to fit all this area are the same, I'm just going to be working with tops. But the Cadence top is a basic, simple top with a side buster. There is a standard bust option and a full bust option. So you will find that the dart volume for the full bust option is larger. There is a center back seam, and I always think a center back seam is great for fitting as well. It really helps you do a sway back adjustment, believe it or not. So I think it's a really nice pattern that if you have, you could work with it as a base for this series. And this one comes from sizes extra small to 5X. I have made it before. I've made it for myself. I've made it for my mom. I really like how the sleeve fits and the mobility you have with the sleeve on that woven top. So that's why I've got it on the list here. The third pattern that I have in this list is from Closet Core Patterns, and it's the Cielo top and dress. Again, there's a dress version here, but you don't need to worry if it's a dress or not. There is a top here. The difference with this one is that this one, instead of having a side bust dart, has an arm side dart, but that arm side dart also shapes the bust and could also work. If you're working with that, I could easily show you how to transform that armhole dart into a bust dart, and it would be much easier to work with it being a bust dart. But if you have this pattern, this could definitely work. You know, it's drafted really well, it fits nicely on the shoulders, it has a really nice sleeve, and I have made it before and I've been very happy with the fit. So I think it's a great base pattern to work on fit if you do have it. There are two separate drafts there. One is from sizes 0 to 20, and that's drafted based on a B cup size, and then sizes 14 to 30 are drafted based on a D bust cup size. So it's good to have the two options depending on what size you use. You will see the bust cup there is different. It might make fitting the bust a little bit easier, or you may need to do some type of bust adjustment anyway. I think it's a great pattern. The fourth pattern I'd like to mention is the Ashton top from Helen's Closet. This one originally just was released as a sleeveless design. It has a side bust dart for shaping. It's slightly A-line, can be cropped or longer, depends on what you like. But they've recently released an extension pack with sleeves, which I think is nice. I think it's always nice to have a sleeve. So I think this is a good pattern too. As a base, just a simple top that you could work on to perfect the fit. And also, not just working on one pattern, but you'll learn a lot about your body with this process, and it will make it easier for you to tackle other projects that aren't so simple like these. You'll learn how to do the adjustments at least, and you'll see what sort of drag lines or wrinkles or things you can be looking at in other styles. I think it's easier to come to grips with these things on styles that are simple like this, but that do have some shaping like a bust dart. So this one comes from sizes 0 to 30. Sizes 0 to 22 are drafted based on a B cup size, and sizes 12 to 30 are drafted based on a D bust cup size. The fifth pattern I have here on the list is the Dove blouse from Megan Nielsen. I have also made this pattern. It's quite simple. It has sleeve options. I'm sure you could just make it short sleeves and not add that flared thing that it's got there. It's got a nice V neckline, and the bust dart is slightly angled from the bottom up. I wouldn't consider it too difficult to manage. I could easily show you how to transform that dart into a more straight side bust dart that could be easier to work with. I think it's a really well drafted pattern that fits well. I've had experience with it, and it meets my criteria for being a simple woven top with a side buster, you know? This one also comes in two size drafts, from 0 to 20 has a B cup size, and then the curve range from 14 to 30 has a D cup size. I picked these five patterns because they have a great size range, with exception to Cashmerette, which is more based on plus size. It doesn't have the 0 to 10 sizing there. I know Cashmerette is working on updating their patterns to include the full size range from 0 to 32. It's going to be sort of like a slow process. But I think with these five, you have great options. I am currently testing a pattern that fits all these criteria as well. Simple woven top with a side bustat. I think I will include that pattern later on as I work through the series, because I think it's amazing and it's also got a great size range, and also with individual cup sizes. But I can't give you the details of that one because it hasn't been released and it's still in testing. I hope you're excited. I'm aiming to have one of these videos per week. This will go on for a little while. It's not something I can produce in a single week. Each of these videos will be a lot of work, believe me. The next video you'll see on this series will be how to measure yourself. I did the exact same thing with the pants fitting series. I had a video of myself. I measured myself, all that stuff. It'll be done the same way for the upper body. I will be using myself. I won't be using a mannequin. I'll be using a real body, my body. And as this progresses, I will be, of course, replicating fitting issues. I will be sewing a ton of bodices that fit terribly to show you how it actually looks, so that you can identify fitting issues. And then I'll be showing you how to adjust on a pattern, and then showing you how this can work and correct that fitting issue. I will start with a system that I think is going to work, and that will start with first seeing length issues, height issues in the pattern. I think getting that right first is the most important thing before we tackle shoulder fit, the slope of the shoulder, etc., etc. So please look out for this series. Have a look in your patterns. If you have a pattern that fits this criteria, it doesn't have to be one that I mentioned. These are just the ones that I found. Simple woven top. Can have a round or a V neckline, has to have a side bustat and a simple sleeve, and we'll get cracking with this. I am very excited and I hope you are too. So that is what I had to share with you today, just an announcement of the new fitting series, and I'm very, very excited to bring it to you because I know it's going to help a lot of people. We will be seeing a lot of fitting issues here and how we can possibly correct them or improve them. And I'm excited to bring this helpful content to you. So I will see you again very soon with more sewing or fitting. Bye.